I'm with it, y'all with me. I'm lost with it, and I'm walking with it. Christians mad, cause I'm a number beaver. I love your hoosier, I hate Jesus. Yeah, I'm anti-Christ, so I don't love Jesus. I don't serve that hoe.
Y'all give it up for the feast one time. I was sitting down trying to reflect, how in the world did I end up in Conyers? Have y'all ever asked yourself that particular question? How did you end up in Conyers? I mean, I was sitting down, I was reflecting all over my life. I never could ever think that I would end up here in Conyers. I mean, I actually lived in Atlanta for a little minute, but I never thought I would come back because I hit the traffic. But I ended up here in Conyers all because this old country dude on YouTube was sitting here preaching, and he made the mistake of coming down to visit in Florida. Had an opportunity to visit, and actually when I joined, I didn't even know that I was joining. When I went down, I just thought I was just going down to see him preach. He asked me, he was like, you want to get baptized? I was kind of like, I already been baptized, but I mean, you know, I mean, if it's free, you know, why not? Long story short, is I get down there to the hotel, because he was already room at a hotel or something like that, and I'm there, and he's like, hey, I asked the owner of the hotel, he said, we'll baptize you right here in the pool. And I was like, the pool? I mean, it's people in the pool. So I'm like, well, you know, I'm already here, so I'm like, yeah, okay, I get baptized in the pool, and we went on and I got baptized in the pool. I did not know that when you get baptized, you're automatically a member, because I already went to other different churches. I done got baptized. How many of y'all got baptized at least 5, 6 different times? I got baptized so many times. I don't even know. I done baptized in the Methodist, non-denomination. I've been baptized. They got a new one called Word of Faith. Boom. Y'all know me, Word of Faith. I got baptized Word of Faith. I'm sitting there trying to figure out how that word, where in the world is going on. So long story short is I kind of feel like he tricked me a little bit. Because once I got baptized, then I started finding out about little rules and stuff. kind of had a little twist because the rule they told me I was getting baptized, so I had on sandals. So I get baptized in the water, and we dry off, and I'm sitting in the lobby, and Boston comes to me, he's like, hey, you know, we don't wear sandals around here. And I was like, what do you mean we don't wear sandals around here? We just got out of the pool, it's Florida. We in Miami, what are you talking about? And I had on shorts and all that too, so they started telling me, and Pastor was like, you know what, so you gonna be up there next week, ain't you come and see us next week? And I was on the mindset, I wanted to say, listen, I just came and visited you. I always hated it. Even when I was coming to visit, I was flying to town to come visit. They were like, when are you coming back? I would want to just be like, thank you for showing up. And you just accept me for showing up now, whatever the case may be. But long story short is that was probably about, 6, 7 years ago when you came? And you have definitely not disappointed me once. And I definitely appreciate you that. Y'all, let's give it up for our pastor one time. Good stuff. So, I'm out of curiosity. Since I've been here, my relationship with my family has kind of sort of changed and transitioned quite a bit. Any of y'all relationship with your family has kind of changed a little bit?
Yeah.
Really? Because I ended up making a mistake, and when I first heard, I kind of sort of told my family and my dad, for y'all don't know, my dad is a preacher. So I started telling my dad all these different things. I'm like, you know, this man on YouTube and so forth, he said this and he said that, you know, the Bible said this and that. And he's like, hold on, what do you mean? What did the Bible say? I say, well, let me ask you, Dad. I say, the Ten Commandments. I said, are the Ten Commandments still good today? And he was like, yeah, you got to obey the Ten Commandments. You got to obey it. That's still good today. I say, so what about the Sabbath? Oh, that ain't nothing the devil right there. That ain't nothing the devil. That's done away with. All that stuff right there is done away with. All that stuff is done away with. You got to make sure we keep all the regular laws, but all that stuff in the Sabbath is done away. Matter of fact, who is this dude that you watch? And I pulled up a YouTube clip of this man just screaming and yelling. This man was talking about how preachers in the pulpit, they ought to be wrong, ought to live a clean lifestyle, is wrong, they commit adultery, so forth and so on. And I was like, man, I was like, he also talked about the qualifications of a preacher. He said, you know, they can only be married once. They can only have a living wife once, and it can't be a woman, it can only be a man, because our church, for the women preachers, and we got, you know, our pastor been married several times, so what's going on, Dad?
Hear me talking.
So long story short is that just like our bachelor, most of our relationship, we start to develop a little bit of tension. So now when we do talk, we have some of the most hilarious conversations. The reason why we have some of the most hilarious conversations, they always tend to end up in some type of fuss, some type of dispute, whatever the case may be. Any of y'all out there can relate to that? Any of y'all still getting arguments with y'all folks? Nobody? Really? Okay, so you feel me out there. So let me tell you about this recent conversation that I had. So he called me on the phone. He was like, man, Dwayne, man, you ain't gonna believe this, man. He was like, your cousin, man, she got married. And I was like, well, finally she got married. She had been shacking up for a minute or whatever. And he was kind of like, well, you know what, man? I'm glad that she got married, but I didn't like the way that she went about doing it. I said, well, Daddy, what's up? Talk to me. Exactly what happened? What went on? He said, well, we went to the wedding. She had a sign there telling everybody that since she's an atheist, that they can't use the word Lord, they can't use the word Jesus, they can't use the word God, they can't say anything. So if anybody sit up there and stand up there and want to make a toast, they can't say anything religious.